Andy Serwer, I'd love to get your thoughts just on the decline and the speed of the decline that we saw today, because a lot of the names that have been working obviously are not working or did not work today. We heard Miles talk a little bit about this, and we've talked to a couple of analysts and a couple of market guests on the show the past couple of days. They've been warning about maybe a 5% or 7% pullback, but I don't think we necessarily expected to get it in just one day.
Yeah, I mean, and you guys said it best. I mean, people have been sitting there tapping their fingers, waiting for this to happen. Well, be careful of what you wish for. We did see some cracks in the armor over the past couple sessions, particularly with Tesla and Apple, as you suggest. But I think bigger picture, you know, when you talk about weekdays in August, in June, and even a weak period in March, I mean, my goodness, we bounced back from the pandemic crash. So remarkable resiliency. On the other hand, these stocks, let's be clear, these big tech stocks, the leaders have become untethered from fundamentals on the way up. So why isn't it the case that they'll become untethered from fundamentals on the way down? You know, so it's important to remember. And just last point quickly, Seana, you know, the stocks that were doing well today, Macy's and Carnival Cruise. I mean, if you think those things are going to get you to Christmas or Hanukkah instead of these big tech stocks over the long term, no.
You heard it here first. They're not going to lead us higher. But yeah, Andy, I mean, that's exactly the point. It's just so interesting when we talk about some of the excitement in some of these names. Obviously, a lot of those big tech names specifically, the valuations have gotten a bit frothy. We've been warning. We've been talking to so many market experts here on the show over the last several weeks. We've been warning about the valuation calls in some of those names, how they're due for a pullback. But again, I don't think we were necessarily expecting maybe the magnitude of this pullback today. But again, a major sell-off in the markets today, tech leading those declines, the Nasdaq and S&P recording their worst day since June 11th, the Dow having its worst day since June 26th.